And welcome back. Charles Mizrahi is one of the top investment gurus in America, but he is kind of worried about how many young people are rejecting capitalism for the false promises of socialism. So he launched the American Prosperity Campaign and is making a biblical case for capitalism. Thank you so much for joining us, Charles. Your book is called Getting Started to Value Investing. What is value investing? What does that even mean?
Well, Governor, value investing is pretty simple. You try to buy a dollar bill for 50 cents. It's what you do every time you go into a supermarket. You don't go to the counter and say, wow, apples went up in price this week. I'm so happy, I want to buy more. Or if they go down in price, I don't want them. You do the exact opposite. When things go down in value, in price, you want to buy them because you're getting greater value.
Do people need to invest right now? This is a crazy economic time. Is this a good time to invest or a bad time to invest?
It's always a great time. The stock market is the greatest wealth creator. Think about this. You could be partners. That's really what a stock is. A stock is a piece of a business. You can be partners with any company you want, because when you own a share, you're owning a piece of that business.
Yeah.
So you have your choice. And what do you need to do to buy one share of Walmart back 40 years ago, or one share of Amazon?
Yeah, that would be nice. I wouldn't have to ever work again if I just owned a little bit of what they were worth back then. But, you know, there are people who say, oh, the stock market, it goes up and down. I know people who, I mean, they look at the stock market like every hour, or even every day. That didn't even seem reasonable to me. Is it reasonable to worry about it on a daily basis?
No. Let's say you owned a shoe store. Would you, all of a sudden at 10 o'clock, no customers come in the store, you say, I'm going to sell the business, and then all of a sudden at 11 o'clock, some come in, I want to buy it back? Ridiculous. When you own a piece of a business, or what a stock really is, you're looking for the long term, the next 5 and 10 years. That's when you make the real wealth. That's when the business starts to develop. And if you buy it at the right price, it's pretty hard not to make money.
Now, a lot of times people thought, well, the stock market, that's for really, really rich people. But now, most people, they may not even realize it, but they are invested in the stock market. Teachers who are retired, policemen who are retired, all kinds of people through all kinds of circumstances. Their 401k is directly tied to the value of the stock market.
So, right.
Do you tell them, relax, don't worry about it?
Yeah, because think about this. Over the long term, really what you're buying is a piece of the GDP of the United States. Nobody has ever made money shorting the United States. The United States is the most unique country ever on the face of the earth. It has produced more wealth than any other nation. We live at a standard that our grandparents would have just dreamed of.
Yeah.
Think about that. We all have running water in our homes that's clean. We have toilets, sanitation, basic things that most people in the world don't have. And our economy continues to do well. Even now, even during COVID, the country shut down and the economy's picking back up again. We have a robust economy, and over the past 100 years, the economy continues to do well, the country continues to come back, and business gets stronger.
Charles, you are one of the advocates that say, and a lot of it in your book, about that socialism is not a good idea, and young people are buying in on it. Maybe they're being taught this by their college professors. Just in a nutshell, what's wrong with the idea of socialism, and what's so right about capitalism? Isn't that all based on greed and something very evil?
No. Well, if you're talking about socialism, yes.
Okay, yeah. I agree there.
Capitalism is not about greed. Capitalism was never the problem. It's a solution. Capitalism has lifted more people out of poverty in the past 40 to 50 years than anything else. And think about this. Where is socialism working? Where is it working?
Never has.
So why are we going to a failed, even looking at a failed, a way of where the state controls everything, the state dictates what you get? If you love your post office, you love socialism. You know, that's really it. If you this country is built on freedom and opportunity, the individual's rights, the ability that I can go tomorrow and open up a business, and whatever I make, I get to keep. And I can give back to society in any way I can. Where is there a better system? I challenge you to find me a better system.
You talk about capitalism from a biblical perspective. A lot of people would say, well, the Bible didn't speak to any economic system. It's neutral. Is it neutral?
If we look, for example, wealth was always viewed as a blessing. Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, King Solomon, are all blessed with wealth. Now, it's not wealth for hoarding. It's wealth for taking care of others in society. For example, Deuteronomy 15:11, the Bible knew exactly. It says there will always be poor in the land, but it's your responsibility to open your hand to your fellow Israelite. Mm. It's our response, and that's what we have done in this country for the past 244 years. It's houses of faith, clubs, associations. We've taken care. Every church and synagogue had soup kitchens and took care of the unfortunate. We didn't rely on government to do that. So the Bible has a system in place where for the downtrodden, for the widow, the orphan, the stranger, those who don't have any social network, there was, if you had a field, you couldn't cut the corners of your field. That was for them. Hmm. The gleanings, when the reaper would come and take his sickle and some gleanings would fall, you had to leave them. They were for the widow, the orphan, and the stranger. The book of Ruth. What is Ruth doing? She's in the field of Boaz, collecting those, and goes back to Noah and says, wow, look at the way the Lord has blessed us. So there was an economic system in place to take care of the underbelly of society, but wealth was to be used to make the world a better place.
Well, I mean, I think it's pretty obvious that the world is a better place because of the United States of America and because we are able to pick our own profession and we can own property and we could start businesses, as you said. It's a great, great book, Getting Started to Value Investing. My thanks to Charles for joining us. You can find the book, Getting Started in Value Investing, on Amazon. And also for all his latest articles, financial services, and more, visit his website. It's called alphainvestornow.com. And follow Charles Miz Guru on Twitter.